Water is important to us. Is nitrogen also important for us? What do you think? The answer is yes. Of course, nitrogen is a very essential element for all living organisms. It is also an important part of compounds like proteins, vitamins, deoxyribonucleic acid or DNA, and ribonucleic acid or RNA. About 78% of the Earth's atmosphere is a nitrogen gas. But though nitrogen is abundant in our atmosphere, living organisms cannot use it directly. So, how do animals and plants obtain nitrogen? Do you have any idea? We actually obtain nitrogen in usable forms such as ammonia, nitrites, nitrates, and other usable form of nitrogen with the help of nitrogen cycle. So what exactly is a nitrogen cycle? Nitrogen cycle is a biochemical cycle through which nitrogen is circulated in various forms in our environment. It has 5 stages including nitrogen fixation, assimilation, ammonification, nitrification, and denitrification. Now, let us discuss these processes one by one. The first stage or process is called nitrogen fixation. It is the conversion of gaseous nitrogen to a usable form such as ammonia or other compounds of nitrogen in the soil. In the atmosphere, the nitrogen gas is converted to oxides of nitrogen with the help of energy generated during lightning and by using the energy from ultraviolet radiations. These oxides dissolve in water to give nitric and nitrous acids which fall on land along with the rain and become readily available for use by plants. Bacteria such as rhizobium, azobacter, and nostoc are called nitrogen-fixing bacteria because they are able to convert atmospheric nitrogen to nitrates and nitrites. Rhizobium lives in the roots of leguminous plants and maintains symbiotic relationship with the plant. Symbiotic relationship means all organisms are benefited from each other. Bacteria such as Azobacter and Nostoc are free-living bacteria. Now, let's proceed to the second stage, which is nitrification. We all know that ammonia is a toxic gas. Therefore, it must be converted into usable form. The process by which ammonia is converted into nitrite followed by nitrate in the soil with the help of bacteria is called nitrification. Bacteria such as Nitrosomonas oxidize the ammonia present in the soil and convert it to nitrite. Further, bacteria such as Nitrobacter oxidizes nitrites into nitrates, which is a form usable by plants. The next stage is assimilation. Plants absorb the usable form of nitrogen from the soil with the help of their roots and use them for formation of proteins and other essential compounds. Through food chains and food webs, the nitrogen are transported to other animals. Now, let's talk about the fourth stage, which is ammonification. A modification is the decomposition of compounds of nitrogen such as proteins, urea, etc. present in dead remains of plants and animals into ammonia is called a modification. It is carried out by decomposers such as bacteria and fungi. This process increases the concentration of ammonia in the soil. Also, as they decompose the organic matter, it also helps in cleaning the environment naturally. Now, the final stage is called denitrification, the process in which nitrogen makes its way back into the atmosphere by conversion of nitrate into nitrogen gas with the help of bacteria such as Pseudomonas and Theobacillus is called denitrification. This completes the nitrogen cycle. In this way, the percentage composition of nitrogen in the atmosphere is maintained.